Well, sometimes there are little things, or you think they're little things, that should take 10, 15 minutes tops to do. Well, this took me an hour this morning and probably a good hour or so yesterday after I finally gave up. That's putting in this board up here for this wall between the cab and the rest of the van, mainly because of these two pieces of metal here. Very, very hard pieces of metal here. Trying to find the right kind of screws and all that kind of stuff, and my drill bits weren't sharp enough, and I think I broke at least two, and had to break out my actual power drill so that I could use that to drill and put them in here. Gosh, I wonder if this back camera viewfinder wouldn't go off when I'm filming, because I don't know what I'm filming. Anyways, you see this here, the wood that I have from the pallets, they're not long enough to go all the way across. I think it's like 72 inches or 71 inches across. So I just put two together and so forth. And that's going to be fine because I'm going to have pieces like this. Sorry, shake it around a little bit. That are going to go in here. It's going to have to push it up and stabilize it a little bit more. Again, you can see there, I had these that are not long enough. So I had to put two of them together like that. But that's what I'm working on this morning. Okay, that's it for now. Turn this off. There you go. This is why you never throw out your scrap piece of wood. You never know when you're going to need something to shim in there to make things nice and even. Done. Yay. Another day, I'm lots of little projects. I think I left off yesterday. I installed these, and then I wanted to get the boards that would go between here and all the way to the front. And I had the boards, but they didn't have any kind of finish or anything else on there, plain old boards. Would that be a problem? Probably not. But I painted them just like I painted these beams up here. So I'm not going to worry about any kind of condensation or warping. Well, hopefully not too much warping or whatever, because these pieces of wood, you can kind of see they're fairly thin. And that's okay. I'd rather have them thin because it's not really going to be a load-supporting piece of wood. It's really just going to be in here for the top of my cabinets that's going to be up here. And also you can see here, this is different. I put this felt here, I don't know, maybe 1/8 of an inch, 1/16 of an inch, whatever. Is anyone ever going to notice? No, because no one's ever going to see this once these are up. And then once these are up, then I will be putting something like this over it again. So not only you're not going to see this up here, you're not going to see any insulation that I'm going to put it between here. I need to put some insulation in here too. But you're not going to see the boards itself, because something like this is going to be on top of them. But anyways, is that an overkill? Yeah, it probably is an overkill. But you know, see what I always say, if you can't overbuild it, it's not worth building. but it definitely will be sturdy up here, and should not have to worry about any kind of condensation, because I have eliminated the metal touching anything else inside of here, so there should not be any kind of condensation when it's hot outside, cold inside, or cold outside, hot inside, or whatever it's going to be. That's it for now. I'll come back later on today when I get some of these boards up, and who knows how far I'll get. All right, talk to you later. Well, it's been a few days. Unfortunately, this process has not been fast.
As many of you know, that vans rarely have straight and 90 degree angles. So a lot of what you're going to see here is not going to look real pretty. Although you can see up top there, I was able to put in the felt on the top and the bottom, put the boards in, then put the felt on top of that. It looks good from here. You go closer, and it's a mishmash. I don't know if you can see it. I wish I was taking this in lower resolution. But I couldn't do the whole thing in one piece. It was just too difficult, so I had to cut it up so I could get it in here. But this will be fine because I will be putting a face on here, like so, probably a big door here, flipping up. And then I'll probably either paint those or do something to them. The other thing I did, put that brace in there. I'll be putting a door here that I can go through. It's not going to be a full-size door, mainly because I don't really plan on going back and forth between the cab and the back here that often, once or twice a week, maybe. And as you can see, it's just a lot of just the supporting pieces around. Don't recall if I in the last one if I had this piece in here. That is definitely sturdy. That's not going anywhere. I also put in the this over here, these boards. Let me get down here. Put in these boards here, going all the way down and up to the top there, just to separate everything off. I will be putting some felt over this also. I have some, oh yeah, I did the ceiling portion in the cab. That's kind of a light brown up here. Again, here I couldn't do it all in one fell swoop just because it was too difficult to do that tacky spray and put it up here without any wrinkles, because it had to go up there, and that was would have been very difficult to do. So I think this will work for now, and then I'll be putting the boards across here this next week or so, and then continue on. I guess the next thing is putting some boards on the cab side of here. And then start drilling some holes in these pieces here for the electrical wiring and so forth. So that's it for now. All right. I got these expandable tarp poles for the tarp I'm going to be putting out the back of the van, but I've also found they work great to support the carpet or felt, whatever you want to call it. The last couple days, this felt that I put up here, this one section has been falling down. So I put some more adhesive on there and put this pole there. Hopefully it will stay up. More to come. Well, it's been about a week, and you would think I'd have come a lot further. Oh well. There has been some changes. Let me go and show you real quick. There's framing wise. This is the back, and I don't want to go back too far because otherwise it's going to get in the sun. So let me stand up. Okay, so I put in some more supporting pieces up here. That was so that I could attach things like this and those pallets. There were some supports that were actually oak, and that's what these boards are here. Thought I'd use that here. That would make that rather strong. And that goes all the way down. Then I put in additional supports here going across. I think I showed this last time where I had these supports in here. I put some down here. That's where I was thinking I was going to have the bed itself. It's going to be more like a Murphy bed. After thinking about it later, I'm going to actually move the Murphy bed up a little bit so that it'll be right about here or so. But I still want to have those supports in there because they're using these screws here that go into the body itself, those screw rivets. In the front, I took out these here because I thought, you know what, I just want one big open space where I can just open a door and have access to all that. I also decided I'm going to have a door here. I'm not going to have a step-through kind of thing. The door is going to be much better, and especially because of the Murphy bed, that's not going to be an issue. The door will probably open out. I'm not sure. This way or this way. It's going to have to open out somewhere there here. Additional supports in here so that when the wood goes across, and I had these supports on the passenger side also. Nothing's painted yet. I am going to go and paint it like I did these up here. But I wanted to go ahead and try to get as many supports in as I could. Now back here, this is where I'm going to have a window here. I think I'm going to just do like a 24 by 24. And then from here on down, it's going to be solid. Mainly because right here, again, this is where my toilet's going to be. So when I'm sitting down, I'll have a view out. Or be able to look up and out. And just the bed's going to be taken up. The Murphy bed's going to be taking up a lot of that room. That's about it. Really just trying to make sure I don't trip any wires when I'm putting these supports up here. I may need to tighten that a little bit. That's a little loose. I think that's it for now. Okay. Maybe a few more days before I do some more videos. Hopefully by then I'll have this all this painted and it'll look a little better and I can start to actually run some wires. Okay, another quick video. Progress video of how the van's going. I've been doing some touching up here, trying to make this was kind of came out at an angle, so I flattened that up so it'll meet up nice. And I also, you know, tried to make all these pieces the same so that it will be easier to attach the boards. I don't recall if the last video I did, if I showed off the painted pieces now, some of these supports. I think I've finished off the back here with all the supports. Let's see, up here and across here. This is where the door is going to be. This is, I left this wide open here because this is where I want the window to be. Not exactly plumb. But you know what, it's good enough for me because all this is going to be behind boards. You're never going to see it. The main thing I want is to make sure this is sturdy. And that is sturdy. That's not going anywhere. And I yet to paint the other pieces here. I'll probably do that tomorrow, maybe the next. And I did put additional support pieces down here. Not that I really plan on attaching very much to them, but this is where I'll have the kitchen counter kind of right here and all the way to the front. So having those there is good. I can attach some pieces to it because those are really secured to the front. I did want to show the side. Let me walk around real quick. Because I committed to having this walled off, I didn't initially have that coming all the way out. Now I do. I was mainly just concerned about it being supported. It doesn't look real pretty or anything, but it definitely is going to support, because right here is where the counter is going to be, and this is where I'm going to be having my bottled water. And so I need to make sure that it can support it, which it does. And I think I got that in the last video, put the sides in. So it's coming along, not as fast as I'd like, but it is coming along. And hopefully more will follow this week. This is Monday. Yeah. I don't even know what day of the week is. Or what day of the month it is. Oh well, that's it for now. Well, there's a lot of wires all over the place in here. And I would love to say I know exactly what I'm doing. What I'm doing is making a mess. And I would like to say that I got that little light right there, working on the first try. Maybe the 10th try. let's see, I got my little power station down here. Turn on the DC, got my fuse box right there, and all the wires going here, and I have a switch over here. That's for the back door when I walk in. And then a switch over here for the front, and you can see the light. There you go. Probably can't see it very well. Then again, there it is. Turn the switch off. Sorry, I can't really see my hand very well. Back on. And then come back here. Turn this off and on. And it works. Wow, that was definitely something to do. Thank goodness for this, what do they call these things? These lever nuts from Wago, something. Make it the wiring so much easier just to be able to do things like that. And these switches, these are the what they call the single pole double throw SPDT on switch. So either going to be, oops, there it is. So got one working. 9 more to go. I think so. Gonna have that. Well, that one there is going to be over there. And that one, and then it's going to be on the same on-off, on-switch. And another one's going to be here. Another one's going to be here. And then in the back, there's going to be a light here, light there, light there. And then for the, that's kind of the back bathroom area. And then for the bedroom, light here, there, over there. Oh, no, I'm sorry, over there. And then over there. And the nice thing about these lights that I have, they do have a dimmer on them. I don't know if I can even show that. I have it in a bag here with it. And let's see. So you can see that it's already, there's a little control. It doesn't turn on when I press the on button. That's because the switch is not on. Now I got the on. Now if I'm lying in bed, I'm not near the switch, I can turn the off button and it'll turn all the lights off, because this is a kind of a universal or common remote. Turn it back on, and I want to turn the say brightness down. I can turn the brightness down all the way down there, which is not bad. Turn it about all the way back up, and that's very, very bright. I want to turn the, so it's more of a soft light. Oh, I'm sorry, that was a soft light. There, that's more of the harsh daylight, and then turn it more of the soft brown, I guess, kind of light would be like that. So that's probably the color that I'm going to have over the bed area, and then I'll probably have the really bright light over the kitchen, and then I don't know, whatever light in the back. All right, sorry, I've gone on a while. That's pretty much it. Now, if you notice, I have to turn it, the switch twice, because when I turn it off with the remote, it's off, but the switch still thinks it's on. So when I flip the switch, nothing happens. But if I flip the switch again, then I'll turn back on. Okay, not a problem. All right, that's it. That only took way too much time. More to come.